Hi everyone, very good evening and welcome for the session. Very less students. Hi Tushar, Jazz, Sagar, Yash, Surjeet and another Yash from Thane Center. I think by this time the exams should have got over. Why all these students are not attending the session? Borivali Center, who all are missing? Who else is supposed to attend from Borivali? See, but they can attend the class because it is not within the time, no? Okay, anyways, so what I am doing is that I am not taking the content provider topic today. As I told you, that one topic is remaining that I will take afterwards, then number of students are more. Okay, now let us do some easy topic for the day. So in my last class I have taken, in our last class we have done all the types of data stores and all is done, right? So today we will do some simple topic. Sagar from Borivali Center, I got your mail and I have replied to you, so just give me some time to check that because like yesterday was Sunday, so I did not check my mail Saturday, Sunday, and today also like we have 8 hours of class I was having, so just give me some time, I will be sending you the things, so tomorrow I can get some time to work on that. So now I hope everybody is doing the cycle test as per the schedule. So let's go to the next session, next part. So today we will start with another data component, which is a topic called as services. So far you have learnt that in Android there are major important components. Whatever you see on the screen, no, Vinod, can you check the projection please? Yeah, so we got the projection now. Going to chapter number 8 now, services and broadcast receivers is the topic we are going to cover today. Whenever you go for Android interviews, please remember you will be asked a very important question. What are the building blocks of Android? So, activities, services, content providers and broadcast receivers. These are the four important components of any Android application. Out of that activity we have studied. Now today we will begin with the second component called as the services. So, what are services? Services are logic process which will run in the background and ensure that the application works without disturbing the other processes. So any service, any code that will run in the background and will not disturb the front functionality of the application is called as a service. Okay, so services are the logic process, they are the logic and some process that will run in the background. What services will do? Service will do some work continuously in the background. They can be for one time or they can keep on running in the loop. and they can contain Java code which you need to run it again and again. Their functionality is to provide some output. They will give the output to whom? To the activity. Activity will take the output from the service and display it to the user. So what are the various examples of the services running onto your device? Like mobile data. Mobile data keeps on running and you get the internet connectivity. When you turn off the mobile data, you are not able to access the internet. Timer is also an example of such a type of service. Music player can run in the background. Okay? And Bluetooth functionality. Now this timer that I am talking is about, like, you know, the system timer, not that timer which is displayed. So let's understand how to create a service, how to start and stop the service. So in order to understand first what do you mean by a service, we will do one simple example where we are going to place two buttons and the button will help you to start and stop the service. So before we do that, let me just start up the device. So we will start our Android emulator. Let this run. Close this window. Let's go to File, File, New, and select Android Application Project. From here, let's give a name to this. Chapter 8 service. Create a blank activity. So on this blank activity, we are just going to drag two buttons. One will be the button to start the service, other button will be to stop the service. So again, I am telling you, service is nothing but some background code and it will not disturb your front end application running. So we have taken this, now we drag one button. Let's drag a button on the screen and one more button. Okay, so two buttons we are keeping. One button whose text is start service and other button whose text I am keeping stop service. Start service, stop service are the two buttons we will keep. So services like internet and Bluetooth, so they are examples. Sagar, examples of services are Bluetooth and internet. They keep on running in the background and they offer the services in the front end. Activity will get the output from the service. So it's like a function which is running in the background. So now start and stop are the two buttons we have kept. On the start button, click. In the start button click, let's create a method. So here, let us go to the on click event of the button. So in the on click event of the start service, let's call a method. We will create a method whose name is start. And let's put one more button here whose name is stop. Start. Okay, so these two buttons, two methods we are going to create. So what is that we are going to do in order to put this? I am sharing the lab steps with you and doing the lab steps with you at the same time. So I have written there, take a new project and add two buttons, give the name to them as start and stop. Now let's see how to create a service. To create a service, step number one that you have to do is create a new class. And this class that you create must extend a ready-made class called as the service class. I repeat, to create a service class, you must extend a class called as the service class. So this service class we'll create, and if you want to make some work do from the service in the background, you can make use of the thread functionality. Okay? So let's go to create a class that will extend the service. And you remember what are the two ways of creating the thread? We have done it in core Java. Anybody? How you can create the thread class? By extending the thread class or by implementing the runnable interface. These are the two things we can do. If we do not give a class name as service, it will not work. No. We have to inherit the class, because we have to do inheritance to get all the properties of the service class. You can give any name to the class. So go to the source folder. Here, inside this, create a new Java class. But that new Java class must extend a class called as a service class. Like to create a thread, you extend the thread class same way. To create a service, you extend the thread service classes. So we will right click, new, and create a class here. Create a class. Give a name to this class. You can give any name to this class. So for example, we will give my service. Right? We'll give my service. In Eclipse, you can get options like, do you want to make it as an abstract class, final class, public class, whatever. Do you want to create a constructor? Do you want to add a public static void main? Okay, you want to generate comments. So all these functionalities are given to you. So anyways, we will just give the name of the class and click on the finish button. Done. Now, what are you going to do is that, because you want to make it as a service class, you must write extends service. Okay? So when you write extends service, we are doing inheritance of an inbuilt class called a service. This service class comes from a package Android app. Enter. Okay? How to create, please repeat. Sagar, right click, new class. Give a name of the class. I gave my service and click finish. So here public class service got created. My service got created. Here you have to write, type on your own. Extends service. Alright. So when you write extend service, you are using the service class. Now service is an abstract class, you can't create an object of this. Click on this bulb and it will give you some suggestion. The type my service must implement the inherited method service.onBind. What is it saying? Service class is an abstract class. Right? Service class here is an abstract class. Try to remember your rules of JDK when we did Java. Whenever it is an abstract class, what you need to do? You have to apply or write the coding of all the abstract methods. So whatever abstract methods are there in the abstract class, its body should be there in the child class, or its body should be there in the class which is inheriting the abstract class. In short, we have to override the methods of the abstract class. So click on the bulb sign and say add unimplemented methods. So when you do here add unimplemented methods, one method code will be automatically created for you, public iBinder onBind, which will take the object of the intent class as a parameter. iBinder is a name of an interface which is the return type of this method called as onBind. Okay, it will take a object of the intent as a parameter. No code is written into that. So as of now, nothing is there. So return null. It's not going to return any value. Second thing that you can do is that if you want to run something in the background, then you can take help of the thread. And here you will say implements runnable. So what is runnable? Runnable is my interface name, and this interface name helps you to create the threads. So when you write implements runnable, which method you need to overwrite of the thread class? Anybody remembers? Which method of the thread, whenever you write extends thread or you write implements runnable, then what you need to do? Or tell me, implement the methods, right Nitish, we have to implement the methods. So which method? From the thread, which method we have to implement? Very, very common, and you might have done it many, many times when you did core Java. Term 1. Okay, I'll ask you the other way around. Tell me, whenever you start the thread, which method is called automatically? Nitish, now correct answer. You were able to guess the correct answer. Good. Others, whenever you start the thread, which method of the thread is called automatically? Very bad if you are not able to remember this, because Android is containing Java and your Java basics should be clear. Right click, say add unimplemented methods, coding for run method will get created, because every time you write implements runnable or extends thread, you have to override the run method. Recollected everybody? Every time you create a thread class, you have to override the run method, because whatever your program will do, the thread will do, that coding is written into the run method. Okay. Now, let's go to the next part. So what is that you want to do when the thread will run? That code you can write it in the run. Okay. Now in the run, I want some work to be done. So I can give direct coding or I can give it via method name also. So let's say I want to do some work in the form of a method. So my method name is some task. Okay, I'm going to do some task into my program. So what is my some task method doing? Here I'm creating a method public void some task, and in the some task method I am writing for int I equal to 0, I less than equal to 10, I plus plus, do one small work in the for loop that assign the x variable a value 0. Okay, but when I have to make this work do, when my activity is not in the paused state. When the activity will go in the paused state, when the activity is going in the background, it is getting overlapped. If I have multiple applications running at the same time, so more than one activity will be displayed on the screen, but only one will be active, right? So whenever that activity will get the focus, then only it should do its job. Whenever it is going in the background, we don't want the job to be done. Okay? So to track that, we will create a variable, boolean paused is equal to, you can give any value to that, like let's say initially I am saying that my paused value is false. Okay, you can give false here. Why? Because we believe that you have started with the activity, so your activity is running and that's why it is not in the paused state. So if it is not in the paused state, paused variable should be set to false. When your activity will stop, it will go to a state which is the paused state. There you can make the paused value to true. Okay, now what we can do is that whenever the onCreate method, okay, whenever the onCreate method of the service will get called. See this. Just like how our activity is having a onCreate method. It is a life cycle method of the activity. It is automatically called whenever the activity is created. Like here, see this one. See this? Whenever you create an activity, we get a protected void on create. Right? So same way, for the service also, there is a method called as on create. Now what you want to do is that, whenever the onCreate method will be called, you want to show a notification that the service is started. Okay? So you can give this notification in the onCreate method of this service. Right? So in the onCreate, you can say toast.makeText. But when you are writing a toast notification, it is a widget. It's a control. So that user interface component you have to add. So we will create a object of the toast and we will say that my activity is not in the paused state, so paused will remain false. And then we will make our run method work. Okay? So this public void run that we have written, that run method we will call whenever the object of the thread will be called, whenever the object of the thread is created. So let's do number one thing. In the onCreate method of our service, alright, in the onCreate method of the service, we will say toast.makeText. Where you want to display that context you can write. So I want to display this on main activity dot this. What is the text? Service started. For how much duration you want the notification to be available? Toast dot length long dot show. In order to make it visible, you have to call the show method. Otherwise, toast will not get displayed. Okay? Make sure that you are adding, for toast we have to add import android.widget.toast. Okay, let me make it simple. Get application context. It will take up the current screen and on that it will display. So when your activity is created, when your service is created, the post variable will be false. Okay, so when it is false, we want to get some work done into our thread. So what we will do here is thread t equal to new runnable interface, and this runnable will take the coding of the run method as the parameter. So this run method, we can shift it here. And what is the run method doing? Run method is calling one method whose name is sumTask. So this sumTask is a method which we have created down. Okay. So this way you can get it done. So create an object of a thread. And after that, with that thread object, we have to call the start method. So create a object of the thread as new thread. And here when we write, pass the object of that class as a parameter which implements the runnable interface. Right? And within that, then you are going to write this code. So once this is done, sumTask method is called. Now what we have to do is we have to call the run method. How the run method will be called? When you say t.start. When you say t.start, start the thread, run method will be called. Run method will call the sumTask. And in sumTask, if the activity is not in paused state, do some work. It can be any kind of work, but just, you know, for testing purpose, we are getting some work done from the thread. So with that, whatever code you have written, right, you have written all this code. Now it's time to go to your activity. Okay. So in the activity, we are going to do this work. Just a minute, let me check that have we written all the methods. So see, iBinder is required. We are writing implements runnable, so run is required. In the onCreate, we have written paused equal to false. Okay. Created an object of the thread. sumTask method is called and it will run. One more thing that we can do is that when my thread will not work, or when the service will not do the work. So here what you can do is, for that you can override a method on destroy. Just write on destroy and control space enter. So automatically this code is generated for you. In the on destroy, we will write a toast notification. Just like how in on create we wrote that the service is created, same way we will do one thing. In the destroy, we will say service destroyed or service stopped. So whenever the on destroy event of the service will take place, service will get destroyed. And one more thing, the paused variable will become true. So when the paused variable will become true, we don't want the work to be done. Because what is the use of running the activity in the background when the service itself is destroyed? So first equal to true. So that's why the sum task method will see if not paused, meaning if the paused has not become true, then you go on doing the work which is written inside the if condition. So this is all that we have written into the service class. Now we come to the activity class. In the activity class, now we have to handle two button events. One is that we created start and other we created stop. So let's write the method for that. Public void start. Now tell me, if I want to call this method onto the click of the button, then what do I do? If I want to call this method on the click of the button, then what shall we do? How the method should take the parameter? See, again and again, don't force me to ask you the same questions. 101 times I am asking same question. If I have to call the start method on the button click, what do I do? Is it correct one? What shall I pass here in the parameter? View, that's right. View V, any object you can pass, which is of the view type. Name does not matter. Okay, make sure that you are giving the correct reference. Import android.view for both. Now, whenever the user will click on the start button, what should happen is that the service should get started. Where is the service? Service is created in a class called as my service. Right? So, my service I have to start the service. Service is in a class called as the my service class. So what you can do is that you can call a method called as start service. Okay? So in start service we have to give that which service is to be invoked. And for stop service there is a method called as stop service. So let's do one thing. Here, press control space and call the method start service. Start service will take the object of the intent as a parameter, because from the current activity you want to go to the service. So let's create an object of an intent. New intent. New intent. From this current activity, or you can also write main activity dot this comma, what you want to invoke? My service. Make sure that you are giving the correct name. So we will give my service dot class. Okay, so start service equal to new intent main activity dot this my service dot class. Add a reference for the intent. Similarly, we have to call one more method here in the activity called as the stop service method. So in the stop service also, you have to give the object of the intent only as a parameter. So you can pass the similar type of parameters. Okay, so this is all that we have to do when you create a object of the or you work with the services. So start service method to start the service, stop service method to stop the service, and you have to create a separate class that will extend the service class and implement the runnable interface. So now, after two things are done, don't be under impression that program over. No, we have to do one more important step, which is called as registering the service. Service registration is required. So what do you mean by the process called as registering the service is that, see, whenever you create an activity, what happens is that the activity coding or activity tags are automatically added. Okay, but that does not happen in the terms of the service. So like when you go to android manifesto.xml of your file, so in the Android manifest, you go to the android manifesto.xml. so in that, see here, activity. Okay, for every created activity there will be an activity tag. So this activity is registered in the application. Same way you have to register your service also. So how to register the service? By giving a tag here called as the service tag. So service, and here we give the parameters. What is the name of your service? So name of the service is my class, and your class will begin with a dot. Or if you want to give the full package name, you can give full package name also. com.example.chapter7service.myservice, like that also you can give. Now service can be given one more attribute called as the android:label. So label is simply the display name of the service, any name by which your service will be visible or accessible. So this process is called as registering the service. If you don't register the service into the Android manifest, it will not work. Okay, so having completed all this code, now three steps we did: creating the service, creating the activity, and then writing and overriding all the events of the activity class. All that we did. After that, now it is time to test the service, right? So let's do the testing. So what you can do is that, save your program, right click, run as Android application. These are emulator running. Oh, it is asking us to save the files and then run it. So just wait. Service class will not give you any output because it will run in the background. So our activity is the interface for the service. We will start and stop the service only from the activity. So this way the program is started, where you can see two buttons are there, start and stop. So now when we click on the start service, we are getting a message, service started. Did you all notice that? Service started. Post notification was visible to you. Everybody, did you note that? It showed us the output. And when you click on stop service, it will give you a notification service stopped. Start service will start the service. Service started, you'll be able to see. And when you click on stop service, the service stopped will be shown. Okay. We will not get any output. We are just getting a confirmation that when you click on start and stop, what is happening? The methods will be called. The methods will be called start service and stop service methods will be called. Start service is invoking your service. So where the control will go? The control will go to this one, my service. So when it goes to my service, it will check what is written in the on create event. In the on create, it has to display the message service started and do some task. So whatever task it wanted to do, it is kept in the some task method. Okay. If you feel that you want to show the output of the service, in that you can give a comment or you can show the notification on the screen. Okay. Cannot invoke the to string in the So we can do this also. Let's try that. Suppose you want that the output of the service should also be visible. So in the some task, what I've done is I've written a toast notification. Now carefully watch the output. We'll click on start service. A service will be started. Okay, we are not able to give any user interface through the service. Maybe we'll have to do something else. We have to get the output to the main activity. Don't do this. Okay, do not write any display code into this. We will have to do one more other kind of code. That is called as broadcast receivers, which we'll be doing in some time, which will help you to return back something to the activity. Right now, just the service is getting invoked and service is getting stopped. So that was a simple example of the service activity. Having understood the simple way or mechanism of working with a service, now let's do more practical oriented demo. So we are going to do second example of the service, which is creating a wallpaper service. So this wallpaper will change the images on your Android emulator. So wallpaper is nothing but one service. So what we want to do is that the wallpaper will keep on changing on the desktop of, like on our mobile screen, and this will keep on happening automatically. So let's create a application which will help us to create a wallpaper service. Now this is a big activity, so I'll take the code, put it into the program, and I'll explain you what is that we are doing. So let's go for doing that. Here you can take a new application, give a name to that as, let's say, wallpaper. We want to create a wallpaper application. Now what is that you will require for wallpaper? What should change on your screen? Wallpaper means what? Changing what on screen? You have never seen a wallpaper, Windows desktop, of course images. So the first requirement of the program is what? You have to have images. So these images will switch on the screen. So what you will do for that is, put the images into any drawable folder of the application. Take two images which you want to swap. So let's go to the Explorer and get some images. So I have some images here. Okay. So I'm just taking this one image, I2 image, and you can take some more other images. Or just give me 2 minutes, I'll download some proper wallpaper images. Okay. So just I'm going to Google and taking 2 images from there. So what I've done is that I've taken some 2 images from website. So I'm just giving flower wallpaper and I've copied 2 images into my images folder, F1 and F2. Now we are going to use these images in our project. So 2 flower images I've taken. Go to your Android application. In the any drawable folder, copy those images and paste it. Any drawable folder you put. So take these images, we'll copy them. Okay. Copy the 2 images from Explorer. Come to your Android application. Right click the drawable folder and paste it. So I just got 2 images. Okay. Now we have to create a service. So service similarly is going to be one class. So what we will do is that first create a user interface with the help of which the user will be able to set the timer that between which two, by how much of duration my wallpaper will change. So do you want to change the wallpaper by 1 minute or 2 minutes? You can give the timing. So what are we going to do for that is, in the activity, we will place 2 radio buttons. And these 2 radio buttons will help us to set the time for our wallpaper. Okay. So user will click on any of these radio buttons and he will be able to check that how much is the time set for this. Okay. So let us create first the user interface. And on that radio button, we can call the method, right? So I'm going to call a method called as set time. Let's go to the activity. In the activity, drag the first radio button. Let's give some caption to it. Let's say change in 1 minute. Okay. And put one more radio button. Let's make it as 2 minutes. Fine. 1 minute and 2 minutes we have done. And what you can do is that If you want, you can add one button, and on that button you can call the method. So I'm dragging a button which will set the time for my wallpaper. Set timer. Okay, and when we click on this button, it will do a on click event for us, where we will call the set time method. Okay, so this set time method will be called on our button. Done. Now it is the time to do the coding for the set time. Let's go to the activity code. In the activity code, you will create the definition of your set time. So public void set time and passing the object of the view as a parameter. Okay. I have to check that which radio button is selected by the user, and based on that we will set the time. So for that purpose, we need to create the object of the radio button now. So radio button R1 comma R2. Just we do for the edit text and all. And make this come from import android.widget.star. Okay. And then let's also put the other references we will solve. Now see this public void set time view. Now we will check that if R1 if radio button 1 is selected by the user, then we have set the time as 1 minute, right? But our application will not take the time in minutes. We have to change it to seconds. So what you will do is that when the user is selecting 1 minute, 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So make the time value as 60. If the radio button 2 is selected, then make the time as 120. Now, from the main activity, we want to navigate to the service. So we have to create the object of the intent. And then that intent object will be passed to the start service method. First example that I showed you, in that only I created the object of the intent. Here I wrote new intent and all. But you can do in other easy way also. You create an object of the intent, and intent will call your service application or service class. So here we need to create a new class, and this new class name is My Wallpaper Service. Okay, My Wallpaper Service is the name of my new class. Now whenever you create a service, which class it should inherit? Whenever you create a service, which class it should inherit, tell me. Service class, right? So we will write extends service. Done. Which method we have to override? OnBind. Click on this and say import service. Android.app, and you have to add the unimplemented method. So onBind method must be written. Yeah. So having done this much, let's go to the so are you understanding what are we doing? If the user is selecting 1 minute, radio button value will be given to the main activity. Okay, so main activity will take this value. Now all that value that we have, we should give it to the service, because service will function based on the value. So take a object, set the reference for the intent. Now pay attention. we will call the My Wallpaper Service class. Now what we have to do is that activity is giving some input to the service so that the service can work. I repeat, activity is giving the data to the service for its working. What data? Time. Who is going to pass that data? Bundle. So we have studied in our previous classes that bundle will help you to pass the data from one activity to another. Now here it is not one activity to another, but from activity to the service. So bundle B equal to new bundle, B dot put int radio button value. Radio button value is my key name. What value you want to pass along with this is the time. Okay, so what is there in the time? Time can be set to 60 or time can be set to 120. Then I dot put x plus b, meaning set the object of the intent with the method put extras. I dot put extras, what it will do? Store the value of the bundle and pass it with the intent. We are registering the bundle data with the intent so that when we start the service, it will carry bundle data along with it to go to the service. Now let's come to the service code. Now service code I have to write more, that's why I'll be using it with some other coding. And I'll explain you what is that we are doing line by line. Okay, now try to recollect, I also told you that the service class must extend the service class and implement which interface? We have to use threads. Implements runnable. Override which method? Override which method? You have to override the run method. Okay? You have to override the run method. Now what is that we are doing at the class level is, we have created one temporary variable called as t, public thread th. And we are creating a integer array. This integer array will actually store the resource IDs of the images. Okay? It will store the IDs of our images. So flower ID array r dot drawable dot f1. What is f1? It is my first image name. R dot drawable dot f2. It is my second image name. Okay. So this is storing the IDs of your images. Now we can't display IDs. How we have to display images? We don't want to display IDs. IDs is only for our reference. So there is one class called as bitmap. Bitmap class is the one which is responsible for storing images. Okay, so how many images I have? Two images, right? So b1 and b2 are my two objects of the bitmap class. Create or import the android.graphics bitmap class. Why we have given that and then the image? Because XML is containing the picture name. Picture file name can't be directly understood by Java. What Java understands is everything in the form of the XML only. So XML IDs are created with the name r.drawable.f1, r.drawable.f2. That's why. So we will create the object of the bitmap. Now whatever work the method will do in order to change the images will be written inside the run. Okay, so let's keep the code into the run now. So in the run we will write our try catch block. So in the run we are going to do or call the set wallpaper method. In services or in Android, whenever you have to set the wallpaper, you have to call a method called as set wallpaper. Okay, so what we are going to do is that here we are going to create one temporary variable. I'll tell you why. Okay, I'm just creating one temporary variable, and what I'm going to do is that in the run we will say try while true. What will happen if you make while true? If I write while loop and pass true to that, what will happen? Yeah, so it will keep running. So that means it will become an infinite loop, right? I want my wallpaper to keep on changing till the activity or the application is running. So when it is basically for that emulator, okay, and this activity is simply an interface to start it. So what we are doing is while true, if temp is equal to 0, I created one temporary variable here, and what I'm going to do is that to this temporary variable I'll give a value 0. So if temp is equal to 0, then call the set wallpaper method with the value b1. Set which image for the wallpaper? The image which is assigned for bitmap object b1. Okay, after setting the wallpaper with the b1, increment the temp value by 1. So now temp will become what? Initially temp is 0. It will come inside the loop when temp value is 0, and we are writing temp plus plus. So what will happen? What will be the new temp value? Come on, it will not change or what? Of course it will become 1. Increase by 1. So if the temp value is increased by 1 and my while loop is running, now while will check, is the temp value equal to 0? No, now it is incremented by 1. So if it is incremented by 1, then it will go to which part of the loop? Which part of the if condition it will go to? Else. Exactly. So if the temp value is not 0, else part will execute. If the temp is 0, if condition part will execute. Okay, so in the else part we are saying this dot set wallpaper to b2. B2 is holding my second image, right? B2 is holding the second image. Once my second image is set, now I again want to go to the first image. So decrement the temp variable by 1. So now it will be temp minus minus. So what will be the new value now? Zero. Good. So when it will become 0, then again it will go to the if condition. Like that, it will keep on switching between the two conditions in an infinite way. Now when you are running this while loop, I don't want that images to swap, you know, very very continuously. There should be some delay, then only we will be able to see the image. Otherwise that rotation of the image or swapping of the image will be so fast that we will not be able to check also. So what we are doing is that to bring in some delay in the time, once our wallpaper is set, and we come out of the if, we will say thread.sleep. Thread.sleep t into 1000 milliseconds. What does that mean? So it will execute the while loop again for after 1 minute of time. So my wallpaper will change after that interval given by the user. Now that t variable that we have given is nothing but the time taken from the user, whether it is 60 seconds or it is 120 seconds. So based on that, t into 1000. Okay. Now why we are doing 1000 is, you know, because the radio button value is in minutes, 1 minute, 2 minutes. But the sleep method will take the time in milliseconds. So if the user has selected 1 minute, then that value should get converted into seconds. So 1 into 1000 will make it 1 minute. If the user has selected the second radio button, then it is 2. So 2 into 1000. So that will make it 2000 milliseconds, which is equal to 2 minutes. Understood the logic, everybody? Any difficulty so far? Okay. Now let's come to the next task. But till now we have not started the thread and we have not given converted our keys into images. So what you need to do is that in the service you have to override one method called as onStart command. So this onStart command is an event that will be automatically called whenever your service is started and it is taking some parameters. So in this method of onStart command, we will capture the data given by the activity. So what we will do is that take out the data from bundle object, bundle b equal to intent.getExtras. From that, read the key called as the radio button value. Check it will contain either 60 seconds or 120. And then my b1 and b2, which are my bitmap objects, they will get initialized by using a class called as the bitmap factory. Bitmap factory is a class of the android.graphics. So this graphics will contain a class called as bitmap factory, having a abstract method, having a static method called as the decode resource. So decode resource will check get resources from flower ID array, get me the first image. From flower ID, get me the second image. Okay, this way. Alright, what is that is saying? The method must return a result of type integer. Okay. So we have to say return something. Okay. So what this will do is that onStart command method will get automatically called whenever the service is invoked. On create is different and on start is different. On create will be called whenever the service is created. On start command will take the parameters from the user. So all this is done. Now we have to do the next task. The next task is to register your service in the Android manifest, and the application should have the permission to change the wallpaper, because changing the wallpaper is changing the setting of the device. So what you have to do is that first give the permission. How will you give the permission? Go to android manifest.xml and here you can give the permission. Okay. So you can give the permission by writing uses hyphen permission followed by the name of the permission, which permission you want to give. Set wallpaper. Okay, you have to set this permission called as set wallpaper. So users hyphen permission android colon name android dot permission dot set wallpaper, and the other thing that you need to do is to register your service. How to register the service? By adding the service tag, service android colon name equal to dot my wallpaper service. Okay, and give a label to your service, android colon label wallpaper service. So these are also the important steps that you need to perform in the activity. Okay, users hyphen permission, set wallpaper, and call the wallpaper. So once we are done with this, let's try to test it. Is it working properly or not? So when the activity is invoked, we will keep less time, otherwise we will have to wait for long. I am keeping 1 minute and set the timer. Okay, unfortunately wallpaper has stopped. So just let me check what has happened. Let me go to the Logcat window. Okay, just give me some time. Let me test what has gone wrong into the code. Let me check that have we started the service or not. because this is a very big activity, there can be chances that anywhere we can make the mistake. Let me resolve this. Wait, I'm doing it. So let me just show you the output with one application that I have already created. Coding is same only. So I'm going to set the time for the wallpaper. See. So this is showing that the desktop has been updated with the flower pictures you have given. So this will remain on your screen for the amount of time that you have set. Okay? So wallpaper has been set for your activity and it will remain till that 60 seconds are over. After 60 seconds, automatically it will update to take a new picture. Means that two pictures you have given, no? So from two pictures it will do swapping. If you want to put more images, then you will have to do a little bit of changing in that if condition, but you can put as many images as you want. So now you will find that second picture file will get added. Now see, this is your second picture file. Okay. So your device emulator is showing you that it will be updated with the different values or different pictures. So this is the complete change wallpaper service activity. I will be giving you the steps, and the same is there in your activity book also. So you can open the activity book and go through it. Okay, so that was about the topic called as the services topic. Now for the next topic, I'm just going to take the intro. Okay, because one very important thing I want to announce, please listen. This Wednesday I am not available. Please listen. This Wednesday I am not available. So this Wednesday you will not have the class. But it, this Wednesday you do not have class. Next class will be now in next week Monday only. Is that clear to all? You will do MR at the center. You will come to the center and practice it. Do all the practice from lesson number one. So there is no class for this week. As I am not there, I am taking leave on that day. So class will not be there. So who wanted to see the output again? Can you notice that I am not doing anything? After 1 minute automatically it will change. It is because that service is running in the background and it is running that thread which is running your while loop again and again, and it is updating the picture for you on the screen. Now let's go to the next topic. So with that services part is over. Now we go to the next topic, which is called as the broadcast receivers. So broadcast receivers, so let's understand what do you mean by broadcast receivers and why they are used. The third important component of Android applications are broadcast receivers. First is the activity, then it is service, and now it is, we'll come to broadcast receivers. What is broadcasting? Broadcasting meaning making it available to all, making it available to everybody, global message. That is called as broadcast. Whoever wants to use it, they will use it. So broadcast, they are used to generate notification for the application. Okay? What are broadcast? They are used for generating notification to the application mobile devices. So they will actually display a status notification. What do they generate? Status notification. What is the status about that activity? So this also will not have any user interface, remember. How like services do not have any user interface? So they do not have any user interface. Okay, they can be of two types, system broadcast and application broadcast. Notifications which are generated related to the system value is called as the system broadcast. Like you enter into a network is changed, or internet is gone, or something where low battery. Okay, so some notifications which are generated by the system related to the complete device will be called as the system broadcast. Application broadcast, event related to the app. Some notifications which are related to the application, not to the system. Like you are getting WhatsApp notification or you are getting FB updates. So even without opening that, you will be able to see notifications, and then when you click on that, you will be taken to that. Like in Facebook also you get notifications, right? So that alarm or activity. Sorry. So that's giving you a message. And you can see the notifications and act on it. So if the notifications are for the complete system related, like hotspot active, or you're connected to the PC, okay, like that. So they are your system broadcast. when you talk about broadcast, there are two types: normal broadcast and ordered broadcast. Ordered broadcast, I'll tell you first. Ordered broadcast is the one which will send and receive the messages in a particular order, sequentially, one after the other. It's called as a ordered broadcast. Messages reach one receiver at a time in proper order. Whereas normal broadcast, messages reaches the multiple servers at the same time but not in proper order. So when there is a proper order maintained, it is called as a ordered broadcast, and when there is no order maintained, it is called as a normal broadcast. So we will be doing a activity based on the broadcast receiver, which is like example is timer tick. Every time the clock time in your system will change, the broadcast receiver will notify about that to you. So you can do a broadcast receiver check onto that. So we can't capture the other events and all, but we can capture the timer tick event of the application. So let's go to create a new project, and this is the, let's say, broadcast demo, BR demo. Okay, I'm not creating any user interface for this because we just have to capture the inbuilt event. So I'm just taking this code. I'll explain you what is that we are doing. On resume and on pause are some other services that we want to check. Okay, so I have taken a new application, and in the activity code, alright, this is our activity code. We don't require anything for on create options, which is related to menu, so I am removing it. I am creating an object of something which is called as a intent filter. There is a class called as the intent filter. Intent filter class is used whenever you want to delay some actions. You want to listen to it and then act. See, intent is like for direct execution, and intent filter is to wait till that event will occur and then we will execute. So intent filter I equal to new intent filter, intent dot action underscore time tick. Now what does that mean is, I want to capture when is the time changing. So whenever there will be a time change, we will get this event generated, event dot action underscore time underscore tick. So this tick event will occur whenever there is a timing change. Then, okay, I don't require this, I'm removing it. I already have the onCreate added. Then what we will do is, we will create a object of a type broadcast receiver. Private broadcast receiver B equal to new broadcast receiver, and in that the broadcast receiver will override the method of the broadcast, which is called as onReceive. Just like the service had the onBind, service code was having a onBind method to override. The broadcast receiver will have the onReceive method to override. So whenever the onReceive method will occur, that means whenever the broadcast will receive a notification, you want to show it to the user. So that we will show it by using a toast notification. So we will say toast.makeText Android make main activity dot this time changed, okay, and display the value that display a notification that there is a timing change. you can handle the other events of the main activity, like on resume. Okay, so there is an event of your activity which will be the on resume event. Whenever you will resume the activity, okay, it will register the broadcast receiver for your application. And whenever your activity will pause, then it will unregister the broadcast receiver. Okay, so these are the two events that we need to capture. 1 minute, I'll just put it at the proper place. See, on receive is a method that will be automatically called whenever the broadcast receiver will receive a notification. Okay, so when a notification is received about this event, time tick event, then what it will do? Call a method time changed. On resume is a event. Okay, what this event will do? On resume, register receiver. Which receiver? Broadcast receiver B. And intent filter I. You can give one more event, on pause. When the activity is going in the pause mode, then you can unregister the receiver. Unregister receiver. What is the receiver name? B. Okay. So these are the two events that will handle that, when it has to listen to the broadcast receiver and when it has to not. On resume, register it. On pause, you unregister it. Okay. So this way we are trying to capture the tick event of the application. Just let me check that, do you require any permission for the tick event? Or let me add and check that, do I require any permission to capture the time tick event? Okay, nothing as of now. So let us run and see that. So just wait for the output. Let's see that. ...8:49. Let's see that in the clock, if the time is changing, are we getting any notification on that? Right now we can see the current time that is set in this simulator is 8:49. Yeah, see now, I got the notification. I hope I am able to capture it fast and show it to you. When the time became on the screen 8:50, what has happened? There was a notification generated, time changed. I could not capture it. It was little fast. So when there is a time change happening, it will show you there that time is changed. So this is something which is happening related to your system. Okay? So now did you notice that on the screen, time changed? I was not able to capture it, but you could have a notification. You will get a notification on the screen about time changed. I don't know, I was not able to capture it fast. So every time the time will change, you will be able to see that broadcast receiver has received it. Okay, so that was about the broadcast receiver activity. So today we have done till chapter number 8. In the next class, I will be beginning with chapter number 9. Okay, this Wednesday there is no class. I'll be taking the next class on the in the next week only Monday. Please make sure that your whatever cycle test you need to complete, you have completed that. And all the practice and activities you are doing it. Okay, we'll end the session. Thank you so much everyone. Bye.